Hello, my name is Tomáš and I'm from Capturing Reality. In this episode, we will discuss how you can use Reality Capture in the field for on-site processing. How you can process your data in the field. Which modes we recommend for fast and sleek on-site registration workflow. How to verify that you are doing well with your camera coverage. Introduction to Inspect Tool. And in the end, we will take a look at total processing time of this Reality Capture workflow. This certain location is a stone pit, and today I want to create an orthographic projection for our client. Since I haven't received any visual documentation about this place, we have decided to create a short video from bird's perspective. Today I am using a Phantom 4 Pro drone, and I will be not able to come back to another set of photos due to their working hours. This is a great opportunity to show our on-site processing workflow. This workflow is for anybody that wants to see progress of his photogrammetry capturing process right in the field, and verify if there aren't any missing data. After initial planning phase, which consists of looking at Google Maps and this video footage, we know a bit more about this stone pit location. I have captured images from several rows in two flight heights because of terrain elevation. After that, I got these images to my MacBook and deleted ones with motion blur or bad exposures. In this case, I only have a MacBook Pro with Windows 10 installed through Bootcamp. Since I only have one license of Reality Capture, which is now at my office, I have installed PPA license for free on-site processing. Link for free download is in the description. The first thing I recommend is to go to Application Settings and enable Group Calibration by Exif. We have talked about this in previous tutorial about Map Wizard. You can find the link in the description below. Now I can drag and drop these 397 images. If you had this setting set on no, you can click on these images and click on group calibrations here. Now let's go to alignment tab and press draft alignment. This is a quick method for aligning your images. Draft alignment mode will downscale your input images to reduce computation time. This is great for getting nearly real-time overview of actual state of capturing process in 3D. This particular one only took 3 minutes and 26 seconds on my MacBook Pro 15-inch 2016 with i7-6700HQ on battery power. Quick tip, when using a laptop for quick draft alignment and preview mode reconstruction, you don't need a laptop with NVIDIA GPU. Let's take a look at 3D view. I can see there are some missing photos right here that could lead to misalignment between cameras and measurements. We need to add another row of images right here, and just to be sure, I will add one more grid of images to the whole area. Okay, I've just got another set of missing data, so let's add these missing images and run draft alignment again. Okay, Reality Capture has created one large component that consists of 716 of images. As you can see, there are more components here, but you can ignore these because this component looks really good. Actually, I will delete them. Now let's analyze actual state of alignment. This component looks great, but I want to analyze it further using Inspect Tool. In order to initialize the Inspect Tool, press I in the selected 3D view or navigate to Alignment tab and find Inspect Tool. After pressing it, we can see this futuristic look with blue lines. Inspect Tool is great for analyzing quality of connections between cameras and tie points projection accuracy. There are still some weaker connections which are demonstrated by not connected cameras in 3D view. These cameras could get more precise connections after I come to the office and create an alignment on my workstation. This alignment will also include final optimization of these cameras, so it will get more precise. I can also create a mesh to see if there aren't any holes in this dataset. We will also create a more in-depth tutorial about Inspect Tool in future. In the meantime, you can learn more about Inspect Tool by pressing F1 and typing Inspect Tool in the help section. Now let's disable Inspect Tool, and we can also create a mesh to see if there aren't any holes in this dataset. This is a more complex terrain, so we need to verify that. Let's go to Reconstruction tab and click on Preview to create a preview model. This will create a lower quality mesh just to see if there aren't any misalignments or missing parts in the terrain of this stone pit location. Okay, now preview model is created. It took only 1 minute and 25 seconds on my MacBook Pro on battery power. Now we can verify if there aren't any holes in the mesh and some terrain anomalies. From what I see, everything looks alright. Also, there could be a hole when I forget to adjust the reconstruction region. I could create a clipping like this, and this would cut some terrain areas in my mesh and create holes. Be aware of that and increase the size of reconstruction region. This whole process of two draft alignments and preview model took only 11 minutes and 31 seconds in total, with 737 of images from Phantom 4 Pro. This is great. Today we have learned about on-site processing with Reality Capture. If you want to get more advanced information about mapping workflow, check out the footage from our mapping workshop by Zuzana. Link is in the description. If you like this episode, please like, subscribe and comment what you want to see next. Also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and LinkedIn. I am Tomáš, and thank you for using Reality Capture.